That's the best guys are the ones who are always training. It just so happens that when a fight comes, now it's like, all right, we train specific for, you know, maybe you train specific for the opponent. I don't know if everybody right. does. I know there's like a kind of a thing, like the gangsta ass fighters are like, nah, I just train to fight. It's like, you're kind of stupid. I mean, you know what I'm saying? More or less.
Yeah.
You know, like in my mind, at least, I've never had to train specific for an opponent. Mm-hmm. But it seems like it would make sense to do some homework, to do some studying, and put together some of your strengths to where their weaknesses are.
Absolutely. And yeah. that's another big difference in this camp. Because before, like, people would I never watched any tape on sure. fighters. I never saw anything. And that was also, like, one of those things, too, like, where, you know, again, like, there's a lot of, like, mental stuff that happens with fighting, and so I'd never, like, look up my opponent, never know what their style was. I kind of was trying to be one of those, like, gangster people, because yeah. the way that, you know, certain people that, you know, taught me and everything, that's what they did, you know, and it's like, and then the Thai style of training is just show up and fight, like,
right.
don't watch tape, don't, you know.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah, so, you know, and the thing is, the ties, I mean, when you have 200 plus fights, you usually get pretty freaking good at figuring people out on the dot.
That makes
so they
sense,
don't
right.
need to necessarily watch, you know, film or anything like that.
Right.
But, you know, if someone was to come up to you and be like, hey, like, blah, 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 like, give you a little insight, of course that's helpful, you
right.
know. And they do that actually too in Thailand. The gamblers will go over and try and tell you things in your corner to sway
great.
The fight a certain way. So they'll be like, hey, this kid likes knees and elbows, so I have money on you, so stay away from the clinch, you know?
Yeah.
Or sometimes they have money on the other guy, so they come over to you and say, oh, he has weak clinch, really when he has a strong clinch and they're trying to fuck with you. So you can't
yeah,
really
yeah.
ever, you know, depend on them. You know, luckily I don't speak that great a Thai or anything like that. And none of my corners really, well, actually one of them did one time screw me over, but, you know, none of them really ever screwed me over or anything like that. Listen to external influences.
Right.
You know?
Will corners do that? Will they, like, have bets on the other guy or does shady shit happen
yeah,
like that?
Absolutely.
Oh, man.
If they can make a dollar or whatever, they would definitely do that. Some of them will, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I didn't have someone do that to me one time, but I had, you know, one of my fight. It was actually the fight where I got my face broken. My
yeah.
corner wasn't really helpful. All they just kept yelling was, you kick power, you hit power.
That was it.
Freaking eye was like, you know, I couldn't see out one eye. It's like hanging out of my head. You know, this big, bald-headed guy. You hit power, you kick power. You
yeah.
no scared, you no power.
Thanks, coach.
Thanks.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it's always a bad sign when you see a coach not really saying anything in terms of technical advice.
Yeah.
Like, it really only works when, what was it, Sugar Ray Leonard, when he's sitting down and he's losing, and his mm-hmm. coach says, you're blowing it, kid, in the 15th round, and he goes and knocks out the guy. Like, I think that's the only time it's ever worked.
Yeah, yeah, I don't really, again, everyone's different, but I, you know, from my own personal experiences,
yeah.
being scolded in the ring does not help me.
Right, they did that to, that girl Valerie Lareda in Bellator.
Really?
So there's a video that's been going around of her coach. I don't know who exactly her coach is. I think she trains at AKA or something.
Okay.
Or American Top Team. And the coach is just like, I mean, in his defense, she was kind of putting on a shit show.
Mm-hmm.
But he's just like berating her. Like, you got to stop with this bullshit. You got to stop this and that. And she's like kind of listening, but not really, like, looking off to the side. So it was, like, a weird thing. But it was an example of that. It was, like,
yeah,
this coach is kind of just shitting on this girl,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Yeah, I mean, and you never know what's going on behind the scenes between fighters and
that's
their coaches
true.
And stuff.
Yeah.
But at the same time, like, you know, everyone's different. I mean, some people, you know, they like to be slapped in the face before they fight. Some
yeah.
people need to be talked like that. I'm definitely not one of those people.